VOV, you're preparing for Stuff Your Kindle Day.
This shit. Bang, 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 click, click, reload, bang, bang, bang. Can't stand it. I cannot stand this shit. Bang, 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 click, click, reload, bang, bang, bang. Can't stand it. I cannot stand this shit. Bang, 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 click, click, reload, bang, bang, bang. Can't stand it. I cannot stand this shit. Bang, 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 click, click, reload, bang, bang, bang. Can't stand it.
What's up, you guys? I absolutely can't take it anymore.
What's up, y'all? It's me again, the motherfucking hot girl coach. And bitch, I'm not about to lie to you.
These are three fantasy books that I think are severely underhyped on BookTok. Starting out with Wild and Wicked Things by Francesca May. This is a standalone fantasy, and I like to describe this as The Great Gatsby, but with witches and magic. It is set in the 1920s, and we are following our main protagonist, Annie. She goes to Crow Island, which is like this magical island, to kind of sort out her late father's property and estate and all his possessions. While she's there though, she kind of gets caught up in the magic of the island. We are introduced to so many amazing characters, and we even have a murder mystery that unfolds. So this book literally has everything in it. It's set in the roaring 20s, so it's got like that gold glamorous parties involved. We've got so many magical elements, mythical creatures, and a murder mystery. It is just so good and so underrated. I absolutely flew through this and immersed myself in this world. It's just perfect for like fall or autumn time of year. I would literally recommend this to any fantasy reader ever. The next book is a series, and this is the Sabriel series by Garth Nix. The second book, I don't actually have the first book with me at the moment, but the Sabriel series is one of my all-time favorite fantasy series that actually got me into reading fantasy. My big brother actually introduced me to this series. Basically, we are following our main protagonist, Sabriel. Her father goes missing, and she has to go on this kind of big adventure quest to find him. And the world that we are set in, the dead don't stay dead. Such a magical, unique world. Like, this is unlike any fantasy series I've ever read to this day. The series really progresses as well, and I believe it's a 3-book series, and there is now a prequel, so you can really immerse yourself in it. It is one of my all-time favorite series. Such a strong female protagonist as well, which I always love. And finally, the Discovery of Witches series. This is one of my all-time favorite vampire romance series. This is, again, the second book. I can't find the first book to it. It is technically a dark academia fantasy series. We are following two characters, Diana and Matthew. It's a kind of enemies to lovers situation. They both discover this manuscript, which is almost kind of like a prophecy in that world. The world we are set in, by the way, has vampires, witches, and demons, so it is such like a fantastical world. The series is perfect for fall or for autumn or winter, honestly. It's just the best series to immerse yourself in. It is a trilogy, so there's only 3 books. They all are quite thick, but again, I don't see people talk about this series enough. It's one of my all-time favorites.
Oh my goodness, I love this question!
I think...
Let me raise a toast to the girl I love most in the started, baby. Ain't no angel stopping in.
These book darts, which I love because they look more fancy than regular sticky tabs.
Okay, those are really cute, but
then I can't constantly do this while I read. Nothing back. Why'd you have to leave me on? Why'd you have to twist the knife? Walk away and leave me bleeding, bleeding.
Money don't jiggle, jiggle. It folds. I'd like to see you wiggle, wiggle. For sure. It makes me want to dribble, dribble. You know, riding in my Fiat. You really have to see it. 6 feet two in a compact.
If you dance, I'll dance. And if you don't, I'll dance anyway. Give peace a chance.
This is my review for Swordcatcher by Cassandra Clare. This was probably one of my most anticipated releases for this year because I am the Cassandra Clare girly from day one. I love her books. I have read all of her Shadowhunter books. Like, literally, I'm obsessed with that universe. However, this book is set in an entirely new universe. This is her first adult fantasy. When I heard she was starting, like, a new universe, I was so, so intrigued, and this book did not disappoint. I will say that there was a lot less romance than I was expecting because, like, I feel like her past books have been so romance heavy that I was expecting a good subplot of romance, and there was just kind of little glimpses of romance like thrown in there, more focused on the politics, the world building, and the magic system. It was very much like a book that set up this whole new world and was like setting up a lot of things for the rest of the series. Finally, I absolutely loved the characters we were introduced to. So if you're not sure, we're following two characters. It is multiple POVs. We're following Kel, our sword catcher, and Lynn, a physician. So basically a sword catcher is someone that is a kind of bodyguard or stunt double to a royal family member. Kel is a sword catcher to our prince. He looks similar to him, and they can kind of put these enchantments to make him look exactly like the prince. And if he's in any danger, he takes the prince's place. I feel like Cassandra Clare really touched on a lot of relevant topics as well in this book, which I was not expecting. First of all, the imagery in this is insane. So beautiful. Her writing is so descriptive and wonderful. So many like bits you can just annotate because they're gorgeous. And secondly, she is very inclusive in this book. So she has very strong female characters, which I love. There are a few queer characters. She's just really, really inclusive, which I feel like these are just aspects that should be included in a lot more fantasy books, but I feel like they're not. So I really liked that Cassandra Clare so like easily included them and didn't make them like the main plot of the story. Her only critique is that it is quite long and not heaps happens. It is very much, as I said, like setting up everything for the rest of the series and just getting you familiar with like the political system and everything, which I did love. I always love that, but it is a little bit lengthy and I feel like it could have been a tiny bit shorter. So don't go into it expecting a really fast-paced fantasy romance. Do go into it expecting some amazing world buildings, some amazing like political and magic setups, and a little smidge of romance. So I gave this book a 4.2 stars.
My money don't jiggle, jiggle, it folds. I'd like to see you wiggle, wiggle, for sure. It makes me wanna dribble, dribble. You know, riding in my Fiat, you really have to see it. 6 feet two in a compact. No.
She fell in love with every guy she ever dated. Whether they were smart or stupid or sweet or cool, it didn't matter.
Instead of hot girl bedside table, how about hot girl tote bag?
If you had to pick five books that you feel define your taste, what would they be? These are mine.
Middle finger with the five facts. Back it up.
My life was a mess, but I could clean my room.
$30,000
Get some money, gotta get some money, never hold your hand.
Middle finger with the five facts. Back it up, back it up.
Not too much though. Not too fucking much.
Wow. Crazy. You're crazy, girl.
If you look for it, I've got a sneaky feeling you'll find that love actually is all around.
well, that's you. But on the other hand, me? Oh, I'm gonna turn up.
Are you okay? Like, really?
I'm fine.
If I'ma be sad, I'ma do it with pizzazz.
Enjoy yourself. Just leave me for somebody else.
I just wanna go home to my mama!
Oh, hey, mama.
Last time you were actually happy.
I might take you home with us, I might give you all of it. Come get your closer, the sweetest pie.
Couldn't stay forever. I see the look in your eye and I'm biting my tongue.
To be the bad guy? Fine. Now I'm the bad guy.
We like tank tops.
We like Instagram likes.
Don't be smashing your check.
We are light skinned, and we can help you.
What am I supposed to do? Apologize?
That's exactly what I want you to do.
Over my rich, hot, dead body.
Now with you, all I get is water talks. I don't get no peace thinking about us.
We're all matter to life, you. Up to life, we.
Can I sail through the changing ocean tide?
Came home to some book mail from Penguin Books yesterday and I'm so excited and grateful, so let's unbox it together. This is so cute. First of all, we have a little note about the book. So the book is called Good Material by Dolly Alderton. A little notebook, cute little collage that the book has. We have some tea, which is like the best thing. I'm such a tea person. Every time I have a book in my hand, I also have a cup of tea in my hand. Like, I love tea. And then we have the book. This is honestly the cutest book. A little inverted so we can actually see what it looks like, because it is the cutest cover. I literally love this cover so much. That's so much about this book. So I'm just, thank you so much, Penguin, for sending me this. We also have an Andy's breakup album, and on the back there's a QR code so you can like listen to his breakup album while you read this book, which is just such a cute touch. I love that. Honestly, just perfect for spring. This is giving off all the spring vibes. So thank you so much, Penguin, for this.
Mon beau soldat.
Days seem sometimes as if they'll never end.
Said that you could let it go, and I wouldn't catch you hold on somebody that you used to know.
Make the most of your life while it is rife, while it is light.
When we fell into a rhythm where the music
music won't stop for life.
She survived the war but died during imprisonment while a surrogate in the repopulation program. She was a non-active member of the Order of the Phoenix and did not fight.
My love. My beautiful love.
Money don't jiggle jiggle, it folds. I like to see you wiggle wiggle, for sure. It makes me wanna dribble dribble. You know, riding in my Fiat, you really have to see it. 6 feet two in a compact, no slack, but luckily the seats. My money don't jiggle jiggle, it folds. I like to see you wiggle wiggle, for sure. It makes me wanna dribble dribble. You know, riding in my Fiat, you really have to see it. 6 feet two in a compact, no slack, but luckily the seats. My money don't jiggle jiggle, it folds. I like to see you wiggle wiggle, for sure. It makes me wanna dribble dribble. You know, riding in my Fiat, you really have to see it. 6 feet two in a compact, no slack, but luckily the seats go back.
The angle of my knife, so it's against his neck. He doesn't look nearly as alarmed by that as I might expect. Not nearly as alarmed as when I bring my mouth to his.
I wanna hold them like they do in Texas, please.
I've officially finished the Once Upon a Broken Heart trilogy. It makes me so sad, but I thought I'd do a review of the whole trilogy. So as a whole, I think this series is probably up there on one of my top favorite fantasy series ever. I absolutely love this universe. I love Stephanie Garber's writing. I love the whole magical fairy tale-esque world she creates. I'm obsessed with the characters in this world. Like they feel like I know them. And I'm honestly just so sad to leave this universe behind. Like, It actually breaks my heart. So Once Upon a Broken Heart, I gave a 4.75 stars. I absolutely love this book. I think it is such a great introduction to the world. The writing is so beautiful. Like, I have it annotated like crazy because just Stephanie Garber's writing is so immersive and so beautiful. This is just, it's such a comfort book for me. It's such a beautiful introduction to all of our characters as well. So I love this book. The Ballad of Never After was an easy 5 stars for me. This book, like, I didn't think it was going to be better than the first book, but I was so wrong. I love this book with my whole heart. Again, annotated like mad, because just everything about this book is so beautiful. It definitely toys with like every single emotion you have, and you get absolutely heartbroken. And honestly, it's a cyclone of emotions. That's the best way I can describe this series. But for that reason, I couldn't put it down. It's one of my favorite books. Finally, we have A Curse for True Love. I tossed up this rating, but I think it would be a sin not to give it a 5 stars. Honestly, everything about this book, I couldn't stop reading. Like, I was just binging it. I was trying to make it last, but it was pretty much impossible. Also, this cover is absolutely stunning. Brought the series to like a really great conclusion. And for a while when I was reading like A Ballad of Never After and hearing Stephanie Garber talking about this before it released, I was like, I wasn't sure if we were gonna get the ending that I was hoping for, but we did. And I'm so, so thankful for it. I will say the ending of this did, like, the last, like, I don't know, 100 pages did feel a little bit rushed. Like, I feel like a lot of things happened and it was kind of condensed into 100 pages, where throughout the rest of the book, it was a lot better paced, I thought. That was just my experience reading it. I don't know. That is my only critique. I loved it and I am so happy we got the ending that we did. I feel like I need to do a full, like, spoiler rant about this to get everything off my chest, because this book had me bawling my eyes out just because I was leaving this universe, solely for that reason. It says, this series now has a very special place in my heart.